अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे इज़ द फोर्थ लेक्चर ऑफ Node.js। इन इट वी विल गो थ्रू डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स जस्ट लाइक कॉल बैक्स एंड इवेंट लूप। वी हैव सीन इट इन आवर लास्ट लेक्चर आल्सो, बट वी विल रीकैप इट एंड विल ऐड समथिंग इनटू आवर कॉन्सेप्ट्स आल्सो। वी विल सी द एग्जांपल ऑफ क्रिएटिंग अ वेब सर्वर, देन वी विल सी how to handle the request and response in a very basic format. Then we will go to the npm concepts. We have seen npm in our last lecture. We will see in detail today that how we can install the global and local modules, how we can change the path of npm, how we can create package.json, or how we can understand the package.json. Then we will see the commands of npm install, npm init. We will see node_modules. We also see how to remove the package, how to search a specific package, how to know about a specific package, and how to update also. We will also see the path with which the node search the modules, how a require works within the node. Then we will see how to write your own basic module and how to link it with globally. Let's start. Last time we have seen a callback functions, but today we will see it in little detail. Callback function is an asynchronous equivalence for a function, a JavaScript function. A callback function is called at the completion of given task with the results of the operation passed as a function argument. As we have discussed in our last class, that we attach the callback function with any asynchronous function, and when that asynchronous function completes its job, that fires up the callback function. Now returning the callback function back to your main application, either it will contain the result or an error. All the APIs of Node support callbacks. A function to, for example, let's take an example. A function to read a file may start reading a file and return the control to the execution environment immediately, so that the next instruction can be executed. Your CPU, your processor will work on while the file is being read internally. Whenever once file IO is complete, it will call the callback function. While passing the callback function the content of the file as a parameter, if there is function, no parameters available, or there is an error, it will pass back the error instead of the content. So there is no blocking or wait for file IO. This makes Node.js highly scalable, as it can process a high number of requests without waiting for any function to return result. So Node.js facilitates the programmer so that they can call asynchronous functions and attach a callback function with their asynchronous function. It will help the processor to proceed further on and help the asynchronous function to send back the result as it completes. This is an example, a simple example. In this case, we are reading a file, we are requiring the fs, then we have called fs.read file. We are reading a file readme.txt, then we have provided the character encoding scheme with which we will read the file, then we have attached a callback function with it. You can see this callback function contains two things. Either this callback function will return an error, or it will return the data. If there is an error, this return the console.error, the error will be printed into your console. If there is no error, this function read file returns the value of this readme.txt, the text of this file, then that will be in this data, and we will print out console.log the data. We are using the fs read file method to read a file, It takes three arguments, name of the file, character encoding scheme, and a callback. And callback is invoked when this read file reads completely the file. The call to read file causes file system IO to occur. Once the IO completes, the read file callback function is invoked with two arguments. Either, as I have explained to you, that either there will be error, the first argument error represents any potential exceptions that occurs while reading the file. For example, if readme.txt does not exist, then the error will contain an error object. However, if the file exists and there are no problem reading the file, then the error will be null and the data will be a string containing the content of the file. So the second parameter, the data parameter, will contain the information. Then what is the difference between event loop and callback? Although events look like similar to the callbacks, but there is a difference. Callback functions are basically attached with asynchronous functions so that it returns you the result, while event handling works on the observer pattern. Here, the function that listens to the events acts as an observer. Whenever an event gets fired, its listener function starts executing. So that is observer pattern. When function is observing the event, whenever the event will be fired, the corresponding listener will work. Node supports asynchronous error handling mechanism known as the domain. Domains are actually error handling mechanism which Node supports asynchronously. Node.js has multiple inbuilt events available through event module and event emitter class, which are used to bind events and event listener. We will do it during our coding. We will see how to attach the event listener. We will see how to get the result from a callback, etc. This was the sample server which we have created in our last class that contains HTTP object. Then we have created the web server with the create server command, and it has a callback of request and response cycle. And here we have provided just right head header information to the browser, and then a string hello world to the browser. And we have provided used a listener, that is the dot listen, on port 8081. That was all that we have done in our last class. Let's expand this example and do little more today so that we can understand little more. For example, this is another example. Now if you see the requires, you can see there are three modules which we used in this example. The first one is HTTP, that is your web server module. That module uses to create the web server. Then the requires FS. FS is your file system module that reads the files and writes the files, read the strings and write the strings. Then the third module is URL, that actually parses the incoming URL which in the end user has sent us. Now next line, http.createServer function request response. We received one object, request. Request is a complete JavaScript object. It has properties. We will explain it in next class, hopefully, that what properties it contains. Today we will see only the one property, that is request.url. You can see request dot, we have extracted only one property from the request object, and that is request.url, the URL which has been requested by the end user. And what we are using, we are using this URL.parse. We are subtracting the path name. Path name is actually the file name plus slash file name. That was basically a path name. So we are extracting the path name using URL module. Now we have the file name which has been requested by the end user, but it is concatenated with slash. So we have provided the console.log request for path name received slash abc.html etc. slash a.html, that will be printed on your console. Then the next line, fs.readfile, actually what it is doing, it is reading a file from the directory. parent the current working directory. What is the path? The name of the file is pathname.substring1. We are taking the first index till end, and we are taking the substring. That means we are excluding first slash a.html. So we are excluding slash. So the resultant value will be a.html, and we are attaching a callback function error data. Now you can see we have not provided any type with which we will receive the result. So I will explain in fs module. We will read each and every module in detail. We will read the http module, we will read the fs module, we will see url module. So don't worry about these technicalities. We will read each and every module in detail in upcoming lectures. So you can see if the result of this function is an error, we are printing that error. Console.log error, response.writehead 404. So for the server side, we are printing console.log error so that we come to know that what is the error. And on the client side, what we are sending is 404, that page not found, whatever it has called, there is an error. So we have not mentioned the error, we are just passing the client as a 404 page. Else, if there is no error, else case, that means the page has been found, the file has been read, and the content is with us. So what we are sending, response.writehead 200, that means okay, we found the page. Then the MIME type, which I have explained you in last class. So MIME type is a text slash HTML, and with that we have done data.toString. We have convert the data into string format, because by default it will be in buffer format and it will not be readable by the compiler. So alternatively, we have to convert it. We can provide the UTF encoding scheme, or we can convert it using the function .toString. So we have converted the data into string format, and we have sent it using the response.write. And at the end, we are calling the response.end. That is the compulsory call. We can write the data using .write, or we can call .end one time, while we can call write many times. So we have written the data in the response object by calling this response.write. It will write the data into the response object, and response.end will send back the response to the end user browser. So alternatively, the response is sent with the file contents, and we are telling that this file contains the HTML content. We will code it at the end of this today's lecture. So I will show you how this MIME types works, and how I will also explain you that if we change it to plain, then what the browser will display, and if we write it to HTML, then how the browser will display alternatively. So at the end, we are starting our server and listening at port 8081, and providing a console.log, which will print on the log file. So now we will create an HTML file, index.html or htm, and we will write a sample text into it. We will run our server, we will test that actually index.html, that either it will display these content onto the screen or not, etc. We will do it, we will code it today, and I will show you the output also, but that will be at the end of today's lecture. So now in the next part, we will go through the npm. This is our first part. In our next part, we will go through the npm concepts, and in the third part, we will go through creating module, and in the fourth part, we will code this example again. Thank you.